सो दैट वी हैव टू स्टार्ट द लेक्चर। सो प्रेजेंटेशन इज विजिबल टू ऑल। अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ एंड टेल।
यस सर।
यस सर।
सो देर आर 14 स्टूडेंट्स। आवाज देते हो का सगळ्यांना? आय एम ऑडिबल?
हो सर।
येस ऑर नो यू कॅन टाईप इन चॅट। ओके सो प्रेझेंटेशन इज विजिबल सो यू कॅन टेल। So I am sharing the presentation. So you can tell that is visible to you or not. So yes, then we start. So in last lecture we have seen what is constructor. So constructor is automatically called when we create the object. So similar to that, there is another concept, destructor. So today we will see what is that, what is the use. So it is a member function. So use of that is to delete an object. Constructor uses to create an object, and destructor's job is to delete an object. So when that destructor is called, so when our object goes out of scope, that is for example, if any function's execution ends or our program ends, or we have deleted that variable using some function call, then that destructor get call. So what is the syntax, how we can write a destructor? So for that, it is same like a constructor, in that we don't pass any argument and it don't have any return type. So what is the syntax? So same as a class name, we give name to the destructor, and after that round brackets, and then in curly bracket we write code. So it don't have a return type. So like main having a return type int main, so int is the return type of that main. So likewise it don't have any return type and no arguments. Then how to distinguish between constructor and destructor? So before the start of that destructor, tilde symbol is there, so that is written in bracket. So name of that destructor is same as the class name. Then we might get confused between what is constructor and which is the destructor. So before the start of the constructor, there is a tilde symbol, so we can tell. So starting from tilde, this is a destructor, and only class name, that is our constructor. So are you getting what is the difference between constructor and destructor, how we can differentiate between them? So we will see the program for how to use the destructor. So again, starting from the header file, we use IOstream header file. Then namespace is compulsory, standard namespace. Then I have written a class, that name of that class is the demo. So in that some private members are there. So private is the access specifier we have seen in last week. So in that I have declared two numbers, num1 and num2. So which are of integer type. So in that we can store numbers. Then in public access specifiers, I'm going to write some code. So first I have written a constructor, and type of constructor is parameterized constructor. In that I have passed two parameters, n1 and n2. So type of this constructor is parameterized. In that parameters are passed. And in that I have displayed a message. So what is the message? Inside constructor. So when this constructor is called, we get this message. And after that, end L operator is there. After that, we have assigned n1 to num1 and n2 to num2. After that, constructor is closed. So are you getting what is constructor? Again, we have revised what is constructor. Then display function we have written, and its return type is void. So in that display function, I have displayed that two numbers, n1 and n2, using cout. Then that display function is closed and our destructor code started. So see that difference. So constructor don't have any symbol in the start, but the destructor having the tilde symbol. And in that I have written message inside destructor. So when we want to destroy that object, we have to use a destructor, and when this destructor is called, we get that message inside a destructor. So this is our class. When we close the class, we use a closing curly bracket and semicolon is required in C++. After that, we have to create the object. So we have to write the main method. So all of you know the syntax, int main. So in main, I have created the object. So here in object, I have passed two parameters, one for n1 and second for n2, 10 and 20. So in n1, 10 is copied and 20 is copied in n2. So when this object is created in class, this demo constructor code get call. All of you getting? So when this line of main is executed, this code get called and n1 is assigned to the num1. So what is the value of n1? The value of n1 is 10. And n2's value is 20. So that is assigned to num1 and num2. So are you getting this? So this is the job of constructor, initialize the values. Then we have called display function. So display function, when we have to call, we have to call with the object. So here object name is obj1. So we have called obj1.display. So in this way, we have to call the method or function in object-oriented programming. So when this line gets executed, so again, I highlight, when this line get executed, then your display function get called. This is the display function in the code. And it will display num1 is equal to message and value in num1. So what is the value in num1? 10.
10.
So in constructor we have copied that n1 into num1 and n2 into num2. So num1 having 10 value, and second message it will be displayed num2 is equal to. So whatever in the double quote, it will be printed as it is, and num2 means we have to display the value. So num2's value is 20. After that, return 0, and then end of the main. So are you getting how we have called the constructor, how we have called the display method? Then output of this program is inside the constructor, then num1 is equal to 10, num2 is equal to 20, and after that we have not called destructor. So likewise, when we create object, constructor is called. When our program get terminated, automatically destructor will call and that object will be deleted. So getting all of you, how we can write a destructor? So I'm going to highlight the destructor code. So this is the destructor's code in the second column. So when our program going to end, when our function going to end, it will be automatically call. So this is the destructor, very important. So when we create that object, we have to delete that. That's why we have to write a destructor. Otherwise, we can't use memory properly, because that constructor which we have created, that is still in the memory. So that occupies the memory. So when that job of that object is finished, we have to delete the that object using destructor. So getting all of you, so this is the simple concept of a destructor. How to differentiate between constructor and destructor? So before the destructor, tilde symbol is there. Then next, we have seen constructors. So there are three types of constructors. So first is the default or parameterless constructor. Second, parameterized constructor. And third is the copy constructor. So what is the syntax? So that is given in that classification chart. So default or parameterless constructor syntax is class name and round brackets. So in this way we can write the code for that. For parameterized constructor, we use class name, and in round bracket we use parameters. So like in last program, we have passed two parameters, int n1 comma int n2. So that constructor of type parameterize, in that parameters was passed. And third and last type is copy constructor. So when we want to copy one object into another object, we use copy constructor. So here in copy constructor, we pass object as a parameter. So getting all of you, these are the three types of constructors. First is the default, second is the parameterized, and third is the copy constructor. So we will see all the constructor in detail, how to use in programs. So let's start. So first is the default constructor. So see this program. So in that class is construct. So in that I will highlight so that you can understand. So this is the class name. So in which we have declared two variables A and B. After that, we have written a default constructor. So in default constructor, we have initialized values of that variables. For A, we have assigned 10, and for B, we have assigned 20. So this is default or parameterless constructor. Getting? So from main, we have to create the object of this class. So how we can create an object? Class name space object name. So this is the line in which we have created the object. Class is a construct and object name I have given is C. So in this way, object get created. So automatically this constructor get call and values of A and B are initialized as 10 and 20. So when we have to check this constructor is called or not, we can display the values of that A and B. So when we have to display that values, we can't directly display C out A, C out B. So when we have to display the value, we have to use with the object. So here, when I have to display that value of A, I have to use C dot A. So what is C here? C is the object of the construct class. When we have to display value of B, I have to use C dot B. Why? Because this is object oriented programming, and when we have to call any variable inside the class, we have to use with the object name. When we directly call A and B, we get error message. So tell me, what will be the output of this class when we execute this program? What will be the output? Can anyone tell?
A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 20.
Very good.
A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 20.
Very good. So the output of this program will be A colon 10, B colon 20. So in this way, we have used default or parameterless constructor in our program. So in this way, we can use. So all of you are getting how we can use constructor. Then second, what is second? Parameterized constructor. So this is the program in which I have used parameterized constructor. So what is parameterized? In that, parameters are passed. So see here, I have created one class. So name of that class is point class. So in that, I have written two variables, X and Y. So when we have to initialize that, we have used a parameterized constructor. So which takes two parameters, X1 and Y1. So value of X1 is assigned to the X and value of Y1 is assigned to the Y. So in programming, right is assigned to the left. So X1 is assigned to X and Y1 is assigned to Y. After that, two methods has defined here. First is getX. When we have to display the value of X, I have written getX method. So which will return the X value to the main. Then getY, this is the method in which Y's value is written. So this is our class, point class, in that two variables X and Y, one parameterized constructor. then two methods get x and get y. So let's see what we have done in main function. So first I have created the object of point class. So how to create an object? Class name space object name. So here object name is given p1, and I have written parameterized constructor, so it required two parameters to pass. So I have passed 10 and 15. So when this line is called, then this constructor get executed and 10 is assigned to the x and 15 is assigned to the y, because we have passed first variable x1 is assigned to the x and second variable y1 is assigned to the y. So in that 10 and 15 values are there. So after that we have to confirm, that is when we create the object, constructor is get call or not. So we display that values of x and y. So for displaying, again in main cout we have to write, and when we have to display that, we have to call that methods, because x and y are private here. So like last time, if we try to access that x and y, we will get error message. Why? Because these are the private members. In last program that a and b was public, so we able to execute directly. So when we have to access that values of x and y, we have to call methods. So first method we have called is get x. So when we have to call this method, we have to use object. So what is the object name? p1, p1 dot get x. So in this way it will display the x value. What is the x value for set for this point class? Then when we have to display y value, we have to call get y method. So we have to use again object p1 dot get y. So in this way we have used parameterized constructor in the program. So what will be the output? Can anyone tell?
X is equal to 10 and y is equal to 15.
Yes. So in cout what we have written, p1 dot x is equal to, that message will be displayed directly. p1 dot x is equal to 10 and p1 dot y is equal to 15. So in this way the output of this program will be there. So are you getting this? Two types of constructors. So this is very important. So again we will summarize what we have learned.
Sir, it x and y is public member asta, the get method cha use nasta kela na.
Last program madhe apan pahila na, ithe a ani b public ahet, a ani b, tyachyamule apan directly lihle ithe ki c dot a c dot b. Pan jar ithe private asta a and b, tar directly te access nasti zalet, error ala asta tumhala ki a ani b he private ahet. Mun tumhala parat ithe get a get b ashe methods lihave lagle aste, किंवा दोन्हीची कंबाईन एखादी डिस्प्ले मेथड आणि त्यामध्ये डिस्प्ले करावं लागलं असतं. जेव्हा आपण मेथड लिहितो तेव्हा आपण आपल्या डेटा हा सिक्युअर ठेवतो, कारण जेव्हा आपण तुम्हाला व्हेरिएबल्स ऍक्सेस करायचे तुम्हाला ती मेथड कॉल करावी लागते. कळलं? इथे प्रायव्हेट केलंय आपण डेटा आपला, कारण आपला हा डेटा हा प्रोटेक्ट झाला पाहिजे, कोणी पण चेंज नाही केला पाहिजे त्यासाठी. So we summarize what are the topics we have studied in today's lecture. So we have started from the destructor. So in destructor, we have seen what is destructor, what is the use. So use is delete an object. So when that destructor get called, so when function ends, when program ends, or when we have to delete that variable. Then for a destructor, what is the syntax? It don't have any parameters or arguments, don't have any return type. Then when we have to differentiate, so the destructor having same name, but before that tilde symbol is there. Then this program we have seen, in that I have written a destructor and it get automatically called when our program ends. And this is the output of this program. Then three different types of constructor we have seen: default, parameterize, and copy. So two constructors in detail we have seen with the program. So first is the default constructor. So that default constructor don't take any parameters as a argument. So in this program we have set values of A and B using default constructor and displayed that values. So when we have to display, we have to use the object. So here object of construct class is C. So when we have to display the values, we have to use C dot A and C dot B. So this is the syntax. Then next, parameterized constructor we have seen. So in that constructor we pass two parameters. So any parameter we can pass in parameterized constructor. So for point, we require two parameters, x and y. So we have passed two parameters and we have assigned to the x and y of point class. And when we have to display, here we have make our data as a private. So directly we can't display like p1.x or p1.y. So we have written two methods, get x, which will return the x coordinate of the point, and get y, which returns the y coordinate of the point. And when we call with the object p1.getx and around bracket, we will get the x value. And when we write p1.getY, we will get the y's value that will be displayed. So homework for you, that is you have to learn what is a copy constructor, and you have to write a small program like this to demonstrate how that object is copied from old object to the new object. So getting all of you? So this is for today. So write your names in chat box for attendance. And if you are having any doubt or any problem related to any topic, then you can ask.